Hi and hello, it's Maria from G4 Central. Today's video is going to be another park breakdown slash history on King's Dominion. I wanted to try something different and break this video up into two parts, so sit back and relax and let's get into it. King's Dominion is a large amusement park located in Doswell, Virginia. The park currently has over 60 rides and a water park. King's Dominion is the sister park to King's Island in Mason, Ohio. The parent company of King's Island wanted to open a second park on the East Coast. They decided on building in Virginia and came up with the name King's Dominion. Virginia's state nickname is the Old Dominion, so that's how they kind of put that together and got that name. Construction for the park started in 1972, with the park opening on May 3, 1975. The park originally opened with a drive-through safari. The zoo featured over 230 different animals. It was mainly known as Lion Country. Also present at opening were a variety of flat rides, a log flume water ride, a steam train, and the Scooby-Doo and Rubber Yell roller coasters. The park also had a cable car sky ride to transport guests between the different areas of the park. Just like King's Island, the park also featured a 1/3 scale of the Eiffel Tower. Opening day, the park saw 50,000 guests enter with a ticket price of $7.50. For reference, the current ticket price as of March 2022 is $39.99. The opening of the park was so popular, the cars entering the parking lot caused a 10-mile backup on I-95. In 1977, King's Dominion added its first drop launch roller coaster, King Cobra. In 1980, the Haunted River opened, a log flume water ride. It was previously known as the Voyage to Atlantis. In 1982, the park opened its third wooden roller coaster, the Grizzly. By 1983, King's Dominion would also add another water ride, Whitewater Canyon.
An underground river unlike any seen by man. You're on a course into a world where every turn reveals a horrifying experience, where every nightmare comes to life to greet you and you alone, for this is the Haunted River. A new ride at King's Dominion for screams and dreams and a mountain of fun.
In 1983, King's Dominion's original parent company, Taft Broadcasting, sold their theme park division. The executives that previously worked in that division made a new company called King's Entertainment Company. The parks under this new company were King's Island, King's Dominion, Carowinds, and the company had a 20% stake in Canada's Wonderland Park. Shortly after, King's Dominion added some more flat rides and added a Smurfs Kids like theme area to their park. By 1986, they were ready to bring in their next big coaster. Shockwave was a stand-up roller coaster by Togo. I actually got to ride Shockwave back in 2002 on my 8th grade trip. Later in the same season, in 1986, King Cobra was removed. By 1988, Avalanche was added. Until this day, it remains the only Mack Rides bobsled coaster.
Is the new Anaconda roller coaster at King's Dominion? Let's just say, it's enough to put a few gray hairs on you.
Now we are moving into the 1990s era of King's Dominion. Right at the start of the decade, a new kids area was added, Hanna-Barbera Land, with new added flat rides. In 1991, Anaconda was added to King Dominion's coaster lineup. It was a steel coaster from Aerodynamics and featured the world's first underwater tunnel. Anaconda has four inversions, but at the beginning of its creation, it was supposed to have six. Later that following year, Dragonfire opened at Busch Gardens Williamsburg with six inversions. Can you take a wild guess which company made Dragonfire? In 1992, King's Dominion added their water ride, Hurricane Reef. Actually meant to say water park. And Hurricane Reef featured water slides, a splash island for kids, and a lazy river. What was coming next for King's Dominion was how I truly remembered King's Dominion as a child and through my teenage years.
The following preview has been rated T.
thrilling. When the fantasy takes off and takes you with it, that's a thrill. When the action is screaming louder than you are, that's a thrill. And when it all happens at once, the thrills are paramount. Paramount Parks, the only place thrills are paramount.
It's now 1993, and King's Dominion has now become a part of Paramount Parks. The park officially changed its name to Paramount King's Dominion. With the new name came new rides and attractions themed to Paramount's shows and movies. While they added new rides, the Safari ended up closing, or Lion Country ended up closing at the end of the 1993 season. First came a simulator ride themed to Paramount's movie Days of Thunder. In 1994, a new wooden roller coaster, the Hurler, was added. This movie was themed to Paramount's 1992 hit Wayne's World.
Something way big has hit Paramount's King's Dominion.
Welcome to the all-new Wayne's World.
You call that big?
Actually, this is a scaled-down model.
Observe as scaled-down Wayne enjoys excellent munchables, attractions, and the ultimate thrill. The Hurler.
So get into Wayne's World in a big way at Paramount's King's Dominion.
Excellent.
Also, in 1994, major media company Viacom bought Paramount, which then led to Nickelodeon's Blat City coming to the park for the new children's area. In 1996, Paramount's King's Dominion added their second coaster and first LIM launch coaster, the Outer Limits Flight of Fear. The coaster launches into a tunnel at 56 miles per hour. It is also an indoor coaster and it's in the dark. The ride was almost identical to the coaster by the same name at King's Island.
Next is my personal favorite and my favorite roller coaster of all time.
Erupted on the scene. It beckons thrill seekers eager to challenge the forces of Mother Nature. Located at Paramount's King's Dominion, became the fastest suspended roller coaster on Earth when it opened in 1998.
Once you're seated in the train in Volcano, right in front of every rider is a sign that says keep your head against the headrest. And if you choose not to do it, the ride will do it for you.
In 1998, Intamin and Paramount's King's Dominion unveiled Volcano the Blast Coaster, inspired by the movie of the same name. Volcano was the world's first LIM launched inverted coaster. The coaster had two separate launches, three heartline rolls, and a rollout inversion on top of the mountain. Now the next roller coaster that was added to the park I never got to ride. In fact, it was there during my 8th grade trip and it was down for the day. The dreaded phrase that no roller coaster enthusiast wants to hear. Of course, I'm talking about the Hypersonic XLC.
The new Hypersonic XLC. 0 to 80 in 1.8 seconds and a 165-foot drop that'll leave your stomach in your throat. Hypersonic XLC, only in Paramount's King's Dominion.
Before there was King Duca or Red Force, there was Hypersonic XLC. Debuting in 2001, the launch coaster took guests 80 miles per hour up a top hat of 87-degree incline and then an 87-degree decline back down. s&spower manufactured this coaster. It was an air launch. By this time, Paramount's King's Dominion was known as the launch coaster capital of the world. In early 2000s, the park would continue to open smaller rides and coasters themed after shows and movies. Tomb Raider the Ride and the Italian Job Family Coaster were also added. On May 22, 2006, Paramount's Kings Dominion would have a major change. Alright, so this is the end of the park breakdown of Kings Dominion Part 1. Part 2 will focus on the Cedar Fair purchase of the parks. We want to thank you so much if you made it to the end of this video. We have some new subscribers and we thank you dearly from the bottom of our hearts. John and I would love to know down in the comments if number 1, you have been to Paramount's Kings Dominion through the 80s, 90s, or 2000s era. Number 2, if you've been to Kings Dominion after the Cedar Fair purchase. Number 3, what is your favorite ride? And number 4, do you want more park history videos? Now, if you're still here, please like the video, share if you care, and subscribe, and we would love to have you back. Bye!